Siddhika. Her speech title is It Happened One Night. Toastmaster Siddhika.
An outstation excursion is the best thing that could happen to any student. Even if it meant it was just a one-night stay, because that meant a night away from home. This is exactly what went through any 9th standard Shankara student's mind in the year 2011. For nearly months, the year card excursion was the only thing that anyone could talk about. And after what seemed like ages, the day finally came. We went to the hotel and we were amazed. The hotel was so beautiful that even the brochures did no justice to the actual site. We were winding stone steps to go to the rooms and it felt like a dream come true. Who knew that this dream was about to turn into our worst nightmare? It all started in the evening after the first round of sightseeing. The girls' bus was the last to arrive and some of the boys had already gone up to their rooms to freshen up before the bonfire. Just as we were collecting our snacks, a few boys came running and they said, "Ma'am, our room has been broken into." When we went, the door was ajar, the chairs were strewn all over, the room was a mess. Thankfully, nothing was stolen. Listening to this, all of us, all the other students, we went to our rooms to inspect. Turns out, three other rooms reported a similar incident. A messy room, but no lock. There wasn't anything much that we could do apart from take our things, all our valuables, and keep it safe. And we went on to enjoy our bonfire. Night dancing, party, really good bonfire. We went to the dining hall for dinner. This dining hall was a really cozy place. It had three doors to enter on one side and a large French window on the other leading to a balcony. The students we had all assembled in the center and we were just hanging out in groups and having our dinner. But suddenly, the power went off. Consequently, two things happened. Some students screamed for the fun of it. And the shadow of a human ran past the balcony. This shouldn't have seemed odd in the normal course. But the only problem was, there was only one way to enter the balcony, through the French doors. And that was locked. We went to our teachers and told, "Ma'am, there's someone in the balcony. We saw someone run, there's someone in the balcony." Teachers refused to believe us. We went to the manager and told, "There's someone in the balcony, we saw, he ran, we saw there was a human." He also said no. We tried reasoning out. Maybe he jumped out. Man said that would be suicide, that he'd have to jump almost 30 feet. After all of this, the teachers decided that it's safer to put as many people as possible in one room. That's how we ended up bunking 18 people in a room that could accommodate at the most 5 people. We had no issues, the more the merrier. We were just generally enjoying and relaxing in the room when there was a knock on the door. It was one of our teachers and she looked really tense. She came and said, "Girls, don't open the door. Whoever knocks, don't open the door. Don't go out of the room, stay safe. Don't open the door, don't go out of the room, stay safe." This is what she said for almost 2 minutes. Then she went off. Something was fishy. We decided to be cautious. At around 11, not 12, around 11 in the night, there was a knock on the door. Knock, knock. We were good girls, we didn't open the door. But that didn't stop us from peeping out of the window. We saw there was no one. It had to be a stone or a nut falling. Suddenly a girl said, "Guys, the lift." Straight ahead, the capsule lift. It went to the first floor and stopped. The door opened and closed. It went to the second and stopped. The door opened and closed. Third, second, first. It went on for almost 10 minutes. We were waiting out the window all that time and it showed no signs of stopping. There was a crash in the room. We all turned back and saw our classmate, Kavya, kneeling down to pick the water bottle she accidentally dropped. It took us a while to calm our racing hearts. Finally, our hearts calmed itself. We were all sitting silently. Who's scared to even make a small noise? Suddenly there was a crash again. This time we didn't get scared. We screamed, "Kavya, not funny, don't do this." But Kavya, surprisingly, was fast asleep next to us. This time the crash came from the bathroom. Six of us, brave, we held each other's hands. We went, slowly opened the bathroom door. The window pane had broken and something black swished out of the window. We convinced ourselves it was a bat. The bat did it and somehow managed to pull through the night. The next morning, the 18 of us, we went and we told all our batchmates, "See, this is what happened." We went to our friend, the manager, and told. He said, "The lift is always switched off during the night." And then he personally went and switched off the previous night. As for the broken window pane, he said, "It has to be a bat. There can't be any other explanation." But what he didn't realize was that some of us later overheard him talking to his assistant about how there were three other rooms that reported a similar incident. The broken window pane and a flying black creature. It was too much of a coincidence. It's been 5 years since that excursion and we still don't know what happened. Two things are certain. None of us imagined or hallucinated about those spooky events. And it definitely did happen that one night.